When we're in a forest, our attention is usually drawn to the trees. That's the thing that stands out, or maybe the plants, or if we hear some birds, or I don't know if you can hear it in the microphone, but that rocky patch right there is a creek. But one thing that we don't often think a whole lot about, but is really important, is the soil. The soil is super important for forests. It's the substrate that supports the trees, provides them nutrients, provides them water, and the characteristics of the soil in a given location are really important in determining what type of vegetation can grow there, what type of trees can grow there, what type of productivity there will be, what's water availability, what's nutrient availability. So being able to investigate the soils is a really important skill. And a part of that is digging a soil pit. If you're an actual soil scientist and you dig a soil pit, you're going to dig something that's big and is probably 2 meters deep. For our purposes, we're going to dig something that's much smaller, partly so we don't disturb the forest, and also we don't need to get quite as much detail. I'm going to show you real quick how to go about digging a soil pit. For this class, I usually suggest a soil pit that's maybe about 30 centimeters by 30 centimeters, and at least 30 centimeters deep, depending on how deep you can get. We want to get at least into the B horizon, if possible, and preferably a little bit further down, but you'll find often it can be a really challenging task in a forest, especially if you run into roots or rocks. So the first thing I'm going to do is try to remove the forest floor. Try to remove the forest floor intact so that when you're done and you fill your soil pit back in, you can cover it back up and not disturb things so much, especially since we use similar areas for teaching each year. So to do that, you can first just cut a square, put your shovel in the soil, and you can step in it. If you need to, you can put both feet in there. I hit a rock about 3 or 4 inches down, but there we go. So I'm gonna slice it, kind of like I'm slicing a cake. And I'm cutting something that's maybe about 30 centimeters on a side. And I'm trying to keep the edges really clean, because after we remove the soil, we're going to look at the edges of the soil pit to try to identify the boundaries of the different horizons and get an idea for the soil. So we want nice, clean, vertical sides. All right, I've cut my square. Now I think I can carefully lift out the forest floor here. I can smell it. It smells like organic soil. And after I finish digging, I'll bring the camera a little closer so you can see into here. There's a root that's holding it together. Okay, all right. So now I'm gonna dig out the soil of the soil pit. And it doesn't matter so much if you're off in a faraway place, but especially in an area that we teach in, where students are gonna be digging lots of soil pits. There's a few things that I ask you to do. One is when you pile your soil, try to get all of the soil in as small of a pile as possible. Otherwise, what invariably happens is the soil gets spread all around the pit and gets stomped down, and then when it's time to fill it in, you can't really get any of that soil back in, so you have to leave a pit. So I'm gonna start digging, and I'm gonna have to dig around some rocks here. And I'm gonna try to pile most of my soil up right here. Got a pretty good sized rock there. That might make it hard to get a clean edge. But after you dig your pit, you can widen it just a little bit to try to get a clean edge to see. Notice the soil here is really black, really dark, and we're going to talk about that in a minute. But first, I just want to show you how to dig the pit. And I haven't seen a huge difference in the soil yet. The color is starting to change a little bit. I don't think I've hit the B horizon yet, so I'm going to keep digging, which is challenging because, as you can hear, I'm hitting a lot of rocks. Hit a pretty big rock. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to be able to get around. Got it. Oh, that was the rock that was blocking it. Oh, okay. Okay. I dug it a bit deeper. Let's see. Maybe I'll go just a little bit deeper. Okay. I dug it a bit deeper than I was intending originally, because there's a really deep A horizon here, and we'll talk about it in a minute. So let's take a closer look at the soil.